Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of 60 Formula. Hope you're doing well today. It's that TGIF, and thank goodness it's almost the weekend time. What are you guys getting into this weekend? Hopefully something dope-alicious. We got both the pepperoni pizzas right here just chilling. Britney Spears is like, dude, I am so happy it's ready for the weekend time. I've been waiting all week. Look at that big old bear nose.
You got a big old bear nose.
Can you speak? Good girl, can you speak? Oh yes, good. On today's episode, we're going to be helping out all the brand new pepperoni pizza mamos and dados out there. Maybe you're thinking about getting a Siberian Husky, or maybe you're thinking about just getting a brand new dog in general. Maybe you got 300 dogs at home and you're like, excuse me, sir, I'd love to have 301. Well, that's your prerogative. And as long as you're keeping them sweet and nice and healthy, then good on you. But today we're going to be talking about how you can stop puppy biting, stop that nibble dribble all together with a few healthy, simple tips. Now, I can't help but notice all these different videos, man, all over the internet. Like, if you click on this video, you can stop your puppy from biting in literally 5 minutes. And it just drives me absolutely nuts because I got news for you. If you're getting yourself a puppy, especially a Siberian Husky puppy, the biting is not going to stop in minutes.
The biting is not going to stop in minutes.
We're going to talk about that in today's episode, and I'm also going to teach you how you can minimize that time frame overall. It's not going to take minutes. It's not going to take hours. If you ever see any video out there that's like, stop puppy nipping in minutes, chances are that video's lying. Look at Britney Spears. He's like, anyway, there's someone's being dishonest out there. Why is that happening? A lot of people out there are willing to sell you snake oil just to get your attention, just to be like, hey, dude, you know what? You can get rid of this kind of behavior in like 38 and a half seconds. When the truth is that doggos, especially huskies, they take time, patience, and practice. You're not going to get anything instantly out of doggos. So you have to be patient and you have to work with them, but there are some tips and tricks that you can follow to expedite the process, and that's exactly what we're going to be going over today. So come with us, will you, on another episode of 60 Formula, where we find out how to stop puppy biting over a period of a couple weeks or a couple months. Are you guys ready? Speak. Let's go.
Pass Mount Nose.
What's up, Britney Spears? What's up?
You got the cutest little face.
Can I boop it? Can I boop it? Look at him. No boop, daddy. Okay, boop. Oh, this cutie. Thank you. Boop. All right, let's bust right into the goodness. I know most of us at home are sick and tired of having our hands bitten up, scraped to pieces. It probably looks like you stuck your hand into a little itty bitty kitty shark tank. So one of the first things you need to do, and this is our very first number one step, is redirect. You want to redirect their mouth away from your hand. And you're probably like, obviously, whenever they're trying to bite my hand, I try and pull it away. But you have to be careful about this. And we're gonna talk about that in just 1 second. But let's just focus on the first rule, which is redirection. Go and get your puppy a whole bunch of toys. That's the number one thing that you gotta get ready to do. Toys are going to stimulate their mouth and their brain in a way that's going to divert their attention away from your hands. If you don't have any toys around to put into their mouth whenever they're trying to bite your hand, you're not going to teach them that chewing on a toy is a much better solution than chewing on you. Getting mad at a dog is not going to do anything at all. You have to constantly focus on redirection. Now, let's say your dog is biting your hand, you know, you can't get him to stop biting your hand, right? You're just like, oh my God, please, you're biting my hand and it hurts me bad. Please stop it. Take a toy and put it in their mouth instead and have them focus on that toy. Now, obviously, I just put food in Gila's mouth, but you get the idea. Grab a bone, grab something that they like to play with, and put it in their mouth instead of them chewing on your fingers. All right. Now, maybe most of you follow that. Maybe that was one of the most obvious rules about stopping the puppy biting process, but it's super important and we had to go over it. And this is gonna segue into rule number two. So rule number two, when it comes to stopping the puppy biting process, is you never wanna jerk your hand away from when your puppy is biting you. This is something that almost everyone does, right? Whenever your doggo is biting your hand and you're playing, the first thing you want to do is be like, stop it. Don't do that. Look at her face. She's like, what? When you pull away from a puppy's face, they interpret this as play. Whenever you try and jerk away, whenever you make fast movements, puppies think that you're trying to play with them. So this very next rule, number two, is never jerk away from when your puppy is biting you. This is mega important, because most of the time, if you're not jerking away and you're not trying to pull your hand out of their mouth, they're gonna get bored with playing with your hand. Now, I understand that this is a little bit harder to teach children because doggos scare children. Kids automatically think that when a dog puts their mouth on their hand, that they're gonna bite them. Even though this is just your dog's way of communicating and playing with you at a very early age. But what you wanna try and do is encourage everyone in the house that when your puppy is biting on their hand, to never ever pull away very fast. This kind of behavior just encourages puppies to keep on biting. At this point, you're gonna want to initiate the first rule and redirect something into their mouth. So if you're sitting there and they have your hand in their mouth and they're just gnawing away, don't get mad, don't freak out, and don't rip your hand away. Just shove something else in their mouth, preferably a toy that they can play with. Today's episode is sponsored by PremiumJane.com. If you're going to decide to give your doggos CBD supplements for anything health-wise, it's a great idea to research CBD oil and its effects on dogs before you get into it. Websites like PremiumJane and MarijuanaBreak.com give you all the information that you need before you decide to get your doggo into CBD oils. And if you do decide to take that step, maybe your Doggeroni Pizza has a chronic illness that they need pain relief from, you can go ahead and find premium CBD oil on both of these websites. We want to thank them for sponsoring this video today.
They help us out a whole lot.
And Rue is going to lead us into rule number three, which is always reward your pups when they stop biting your hand. Now, this is something that's kind of hard to do as well, because you never really pay attention to the times when they're not biting your hand. You're only paying attention to the times when they are biting your hand, right? So it's almost like you can only teach them when they're doing something bad. But that's not the case. You need to pay attention to the times when they're playing with a toy instead of playing with your hand. And when they're sitting there on the ground, you know, gnawing away at a bone or having a good time with a tennis ball, just walk up to them and be like, good doggo, that's a really good job. You guys did a really good job. Thank you so much for not chewing on my hand and playing with the rope on the floor. Remember, positive behavior goes such a long way with doggos. They really respond much better to it than negative behavior. Remember, it's never going to take just minutes to get your husky or your puppy to stop biting at a young age. Huskies and all dogs lose their teeth between 5 and 7 months old, and they will eventually teethe at that point anyways. Mouthing is just part of the growing up process of every dog, and inevitably it will always take months to grow out of. Just be prepared to go through it and ease them out of it in a positive way. We want to thank you guys so much for hanging out with us today. We had a blast teaching you guys how to properly and effectively teach your Huskeroni Pizza to stop biting. She's like, I'm just sitting my big old donut booty over here on the floor the whole episode. If you guys had fun, don't forget to smash that like button, hit subscribe if you want to see more Huskeroni Pizza episodes, and we'll see you next time with another episode of Guess What? Yep, Whatever We Make.
Peace!